Good morning, my dear students. Let us discuss about perspectives of a management subject. It is belongs to the MBA subject. Perspectives of management subject is a foundation for the MBA and BBA also. Contents of a perspectives of management subject is introduction to the management, nature of management, scope of management, importance of management, functions of management. Introduction to management. Management involves the activities to control and monitor the people in an organization to achieve desired goals of the organization. Here, management is involves in the organization to controlling the activities of the employees in the organization and monitoring the employees in the organization. Management is very important in the organization here. And people also very important in the organization. What is the importance of the management in the organization means, it is by the help of management only employees can achieve their desired goals in the organization. There are different roles of management, including organizing, planning, staffing, directing, monitoring, and the employees. And there are different roles of management, those are planning, organizing, staffing, directing, monitoring the employees. These are the important management functions. By the help of these management functions only, organization will be run in a successful manner. A manager directs the people to perform their task with ultimate result in gaining the goals of employees. Here, management also deals with the allocation, planning, and manipulation of resources available to the organization. Here, management always dealing with the planning. See, here management is giving the more importance to the planning. When they are giving the importance of the planning means, there is a very big reason behind on their decision. Means planning is very important here. And manipulation of resources available to the organization. And in recent years, the concept of management has changed because of decentralization in the organization. Previously, organization and management is thinking is different compared to now. Present decentralization adopting the new technique, so organization mindset also changes. Today, management facilitate the activities of workers instead of controlling them. Today, management is facilitating various type of activities towards the workers instead of controlling them. And here, one other, Fairland defines the management as a process by the which managers create, direct, maintain, and operate purposive organizations through a systematic and coordinate cooperate human effort. He is saying that management is a process. In this process, here manager will create and direct, maintain and operate purposive organization through systematic process by the help of coordination of employees and cooperation of employees and human effort is plays a very important role in the management. Nature of the management contains universal process, factor of the production, goal-oriented, supreme thought and action, group activity, dynamic function and social science, important organ of society, system of authority, profession, process. Coming to the universal process, here universal process is saying that where there is a human activity, there is a management. Where there is a human activity, there is a management. Without efficient management, we cannot achieve the objectives of a company. And here, human activity is very important factor in the organization for achieving the success. Means, and here universal process is saying another important thing is where there is a human activity, compulsory management requires there. Without efficient management, the objectives of a company cannot be achieved. Coming to the factor of production. Here, qualified and efficient managers are essential to utilization of labor and capital. Factor of the production is telling that to controlling the people, to direct and manage and work assigning to the employees, we need a qualified person. Efficient manager are essential to utilization of labor and capital resources of organization. Coming to goal oriented, the most important goal of all management activities is to accomplish the objectives of an enterprise. The goal should be a realistic and attainable form. The success of management is measured by the extent to which the established goals are achieved. Thus, management is a purposeful. Supreme in thought and action, managers set realize objectives and then mastermind action on all front to accomplish them. Here manager set realize the objectives. Management is setting the realizing the objectives in the future course of action and mastermind action on all front to accomplish them. For this, they require full support from the middle level of employees and low level of employees. These are also called as middle level of management and lower level of management. Coming to the group activity, all human physical resources should be efficiently coordinated to attain maximum level of combined productivity. All human and physical resources should be efficiently coordinated to attain maximum level of combined productivity. Without coordination, no work would be accomplished. Here, coordination and cooperation plays a vital role in the organization. Without proper coordination or proper cooperation, any work will not be completed in a successful manner. Coming to the dynamic function. Here, management is a dynamic function. Management should be equipped to face the changes in the business environment brought by various factors. Here, running the business is not a very simple task. In future, we will get number of problems in various sectors by the economical side, social side, political side, technological or human factors. They must be adequate training so that can able to them perform well even in critical situations. Here, management should be a dynamic function. He is saying that in business field, we will get a number of problems from various sides, economical side or social side, political side or technological side or human factor. So we should be have the adequate training towards the employees and management to overcome all those difficulties in critical situations. Social science. Management is also called as a social science. All individuals that a manager deals with have different level of sensitivity. Here, all individuals that manager deals with have a different level of sensitivity. Here, manager is dealing the all level of employees in a different level of sensitivity and understanding the three level of employees in a different manner and using the dynamism also to understanding the employees in the organization. Coming to the important organ of society. Society influences managerial action and managerial action influences the society. Here society is influencing the managerial action and managerial action is influencing the society. It's manager responsibility that they should also contribute toward the society by organization charity. Here society is influencing the management action and managerial action is influencing the society. Here manager is saying that manager should have the responsibility that they should also contribute toward the society by organizing charity functions, sport competitions, a donation to the NGOs. NGOs means non-government organization. To establish a company, we need a public support. So, by the public support only, we are getting the land and other support towards the organization. So, we want to do a favor to the society. That is called corporate social responsibility. In the same manner, here author is saying that manager should have a responsibility that they want to contribute toward the society by organizing charity functions. for sport competitions, a donation to the NGOs and etc. Coming to systematic authority, well-defined lines of a command. Here, everything, every position of a designation in the organization is well-defined lines of a command here. CEO is having the different rules, manager is having the different rules, and subordinate having the different guidelines. Here, for every designation of a job is well-defined lines of a command, and delegation of a suitable authority, responsibility at all levels of decision making. Here, every person is doing job in different levels. Means here delegation is suitable for their authority and responsibility at all levels of decision making. This is necessary to that each individual should what is expected from him and to whom he needs to report. And coming to the profession, managers need to process managerial knowledge. Here, managers need to possess managerial knowledge and training and have to conform a recognized code of conduct. Here, manager want to provide the knowledge towards his employees in the organization, and he want to provide training towards the employees and conform, recognize the code of conduct and remain consciousness of their social and human obligations in the organization. Scope of a management. Here, scope of management is telling about production management, marketing management, financial management, and personnel management. Personnel management and human resource management both are one. Coming to the production management, different type of activities are taking place in production management. Here, the product is designing here, and planning and controlling operations of a product, and research and development operations of a product, and quality controlling of a product taking place in the production management. Coming to the marketing management, marketing research is taking place in marketing management, and planning for the new products, setting the prices and channels of distribution in marketing management happens. And here, promotional activities like advertising and salesmanship to communicate with the customers. Here, promotional activities are taken place in the marketing management. Promotional activities means advertising. Here, product advertising is happening, and salesman is communicating to the customers about the particular details of a particular product. And coming to the financial management, estimating funds for both long run and short term business need. In the financial management, here estimation is happening for the funds for the both long term and short term business need, and selecting the appropriate source of funds and raising the required funds at the right time, and proper utilization of funds are happening in financial management. Financial management involves the planning, organizing, controlling of the financial resources. And coming to the personal management, personal management and human resource management both are one. Here, manpower is planning here, and number of recruitments are taken place here, and selecting of the employee, training of the employee are happens here, and performance appraisal, compensation, employee welfare activities and services are taken here, and personal records and research and promotional transfers in this like different activities of belongs to the human and the employees are taken place in the personal management only. Importance of a management helps in achieving the group goals. Here, management is helping for the achieve the group goals in the organization, and by the help of management only we are utilizing the resources in an optimum manner. By the help of the management only we are reducing the cost in the organization. Establishing a sound organization by the help of the management. Sound organization is nothing but good organization, reputation of the organization. Here, by the help of management only maintains equilibrium, essential for a personality of the society. Here, there are different managerial roles in the management. Here, managerial roles is classified into three different ways: intrapersonal roles, informational roles, and decisional roles. Here, intrapersonal roles is tells about figurehead roles and leader role and liaison role. Coming to the informational roles means it tells about monitor roles and disseminator roles, spokesman roles. Coming to the decisional roles means it tells about the entrepreneurial roles and disturbance handler roles and resource allocators role, negotiators role. Basic management functions. Functions of management. Functions of management is very important topic in the perspectives of management. Here there are mainly five different functions: planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. Coming to the planning. Planning is very important function of the management. Planning is very first function of the management. Here management helps in deciding the way ahead for any organization. Here management is helping in deciding anything of the organization, what to do in furtherly in future. It involves deeply analyzing the marketing trends according to the marketing views and plans. Here planning is helping for the management for deeply analyzing the market trends in the present situation, and by the analyzing the marketing trends in the future only, they are according to making the moves and plans to satisfy the customers in the market. Basically, it means setting the goals and developing a method to achieve them efficiently. That being said, planning cannot be prevent the problems. Here he is saying that planning not only prevent the problems, but it can definitely provide a way to deal with the things when they go out of the hand. Here planning cannot be prevent the problems, but it can provide a way how to deal the those things in a good manner. For example, when principles of management are applied for a company selling a product, they help in the planning the quantities of the product, type of the product, methods of the producing, etc. in order to perform well in the market and avoided losses in the market. In this way, planning is very important functions in the management functions. Organization. Organizing also very important management functions in the perspectives of management. Once a plan is laid out, its a proper implementation lies somewhat in the next functions of management. This function helps in establishing the authorities. By the help of organizing only, here we are establishing the authorities and dividing the workloads and assigning the responsibilities towards employees. We are grouping the tasks and allocating resources by the help of organizing function only. Here tasks are different into various departments and resources required for the completion of tasks are distributed. Organizing involves the grouping of employees required tasks into the manageable department or work units. Here organizing is involving the group oriented tasks. Here every organization is dividing the employees into different departments and different groups, and they are assigning the tasks to the different teams in different departments to achieve the organization goal in a good manner. And establishment of authority and reporting relationship within the organizational hierarchy. In the organizing, establishment of authority is very important. Reporting the relationships within the organizational hierarchy also very important. And next, staffing. Staffing is nothing but we can say simply finding and building the appropriate staff. Until unless the right people aren't employed in the correct completion of task, we want to appoint the right employee in the organization. Without employing a right person in the organization, we cannot complete the task in the organization. And hence this management functions ensures that suitable staff is available when needed by the organization for completion of a task. Here staffing is saying that when the company is having the requirement of a correct employee, we want to immediately hire the employee for completion of that task particularly. And also known as human resource function. Staffing is nothing but human resource function. It involves the recruitment, placement, selection and training. Next, directing. This functions of management involves the guiding the team towards the right direction by leading, motivating and encouraging them. Here directing is very important functions in the management functions. The directing will lead the employees, motivate the employees, encourage the employees. Working in a positive environment of a motivation and encouragement brings out the best in a people. All the employees we want to motivate in a good environment. Employees always should be in a positive environment. Then only you will get a fruitful results in the organization. Hence, a good manager makes sure to encourage, criticize or her subordinates at a suitable time. Always good manager will motivate the employees, encourage the employees to achieve the success in the organization. Controlling. Finally, a manager's need to the ensure the standards and being met by the company. Finally, ultimate goal of a management is to establish the standards in the company. The controlling function involves the setting up performance standards. Here, main function is we want to setting up the performance standards in the organization. Measuring the performance is important task and comparing them to the established standards. Every good organization sets a benchmark for the performance which is required to be fulfilled. Here benchmark means it is one of the standards in the organization. It is a managerial function to keep this in the check. Further, it is the duty of a manager to take appropriate steps when such standards are not met. Lastly, the management decides to action, which play a significant role in the success. How and where they can be measured and who should have the authority to take a corrective action. Finally, controlling is saying that how and where they can be measured and who should have the authority to take a corrective actions. Here controlling is telling that who should have the proper authority, who should want to take a corrective actions, in which way they want to measure the performance and in which way they want to establish a benchmark standards in the organization. Thank you, my dear students. Please subscribe my YouTube channel.